Historians don't know much about Johnson County before the 1820s. They do know it was a hunting ground for the Kansas Indians.
These are peoples that have oral traditions. They're not leaving written records of their time, of their perceptions of the land.
In the 1820s and 30s, the U.S. government moved the Shawnee tribe to this land. Missionaries soon followed. The best known was the Reverend Thomas Johnson, for whom the county was named. He started the Shawnee Indian Mission. Soon after that, more white settlers arrived and started farming. Johnson County was established in 1855, 6 years before Kansas became a state. In those years, violence spread in bleeding Kansas as pro-slavery and anti-slavery factions fought over the future of slavery.
There were some towns that were established in Johnson County as abolitionist towns. Gardner is one of those towns. But there was also towns that were on the pro-slavery side.
Kansas came into the Union as a free state in 1861. After the Civil War, the Kansas City region grew thanks to a new railroad bridge and busy travel on three famous trails to the west. Johnson County grew right along with it. This one-room schoolhouse near Edgerton provides a taste of that era. The Lanesfield School opened in 1869. Today, the county preserves it as a museum. At one time, the Santa Fe Trail passed right by here.
Students actually in the 1870s could watch the wagons roll by. So we have a lot of trail seekers. We have students come in.
It was a way of life dominated by agriculture. But in the 20th century, it began to change. World War II brought industrialization. The Olathe Naval Air Station began operations in 1942, and that same year, the Sunflower Army Ammunition Plant opened near DeSoto.
At its height, the plant was operating 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and employing over 12,000 workers.
After the war, FHA loans and the GI Bill made homeownership possible for the first time for many Americans. It led to a housing boom in Johnson County.
Quickly, cities begin to incorporate, and we see a lot of the cities in the northeast part of the county incorporate in the 1950s. Prairie Village, Mission, Overland Park incorporates in 1960.
The all-electric house personified the era when it was built in Prairie Village in 1954. Today, it's on display at the Johnson County Museum. Back then, Kansas City Power and Light constructed it as a model home to show off all the latest electronic gadgets of that time. It was a time of explosive growth in Johnson County.
In 1950, the population was 62,000 people, and it had doubled from 1940 to 1950. It doubles again by 1960.
In the 70s, the county continued to grow. Johnson County Community College opened its new campus on College Boulevard, and a new office park, Corporate Woods, sprung up along I-435.
And it really was a major player in Johnson County, beginning to see more jobs being moved into the suburban areas. Today, more people travel into Johnson County for work than leave the county. And many people live and work both in Johnson County, and that's a major shift.
In 1994, Johnson County opened the New Century Air Center in Gardner. As the county moved from the 90s into the new century, it embraced new challenges posed by a changing economy.
Early on, the companies that were moving out to Johnson County were many of the professional companies. There were engineering firms and financial firms and law offices. In the mid to late 90s and into 2000s, you start to see many of those companies being tech companies.
It also embraced the increasing diversity in the makeup of its citizens. Long gone were the restrictive housing covenants of the post-World War II era.
We have a much more diverse population. We see a lot of growth in different ethnic groups in the county.
It's changed a lot since the Kansas first hunted here, and Johnson County is expected to continue growing well into the 21st century. For Johnson County Government, I'm Eric Schultz.